My visit to Harvard University, Boston, is not only symbolic at this point, but equally prophetic.
Okay.
You know, right from the onset, that is talking about the establishment of Covenant University, we've always taken Covenant University to be the new generation Harvard. And if I'm not mistaken, if not until I got the invitation to be there, we've not had any contact with them, we've not had any dealing with them. But here we are on a platter of gold. I got this invitation to attend a cancer summit on a platter of gold. All expenses paid for, and to discuss the issue called, titled, The Use of ICT to Forge High Power Collaboration, Education, and Cure of Cancer. If you look at the number of universities we have in Nigeria, maybe currently put at 138, and if you look at the number of universities we have in Africa, highly enormous. But out of all this, attending the conference, I observed that I was the only professor of computer science based in Africa who was invited to give a talk. And it was not until I got there that I discovered that actually we had two professors of ICT, one from Covenant University, Nigeria, Africa, the other came from the US, and coincidentally, a friend of the university, my own friend, a visiting professor to Covenant University, and my Fulbright host during my Fulbright fellowship, talking about Professor Victor Mbarika, were the two that actually contributed on the possibility of the adoption of ICT towards the care of cancer. The population of the world currently put at 7.3 billion. And we have the level of diffusion of mobile devices put at 6.9 billion. The level of diffusion of internet is just 2.9 billion. So without missing words, it was easier for me along the line of my past research projects that I've done in the area of e-voting, e-democracy, e-payment, e-opinion poll, to just say, if Nigeria with a population put at 170 million, we have over that number, talking about the number of mobile devices, then one should be able to establish a one-to-one mapping between an individual and the mobile devices. However, we are not unmindful of the fact that you could have an individual having up to 2-3 devices. But the bottom line is, if we are looking for an avenue toward by which we can reach into the general populace in any nation in the world, looking at the population of the world, looking at the number of mobile devices available, the mobile platform is definitely an acceptable one. I had to dwell on my past projects, and having succeeded with proofs of concept, it was easier for the whole assembly to agree. Definitely, the mobile platform is one way we can go, and that Covenant University will just be one institution that can help to drive this in the continent of Africa. Ever since 2003, the whole world has been focusing on application of ICT to health, which we call today e-health, application of ICT to education, which we refer to as e-education, application of ICT to governance, which we call e-governance. So, and if you look at the ranking of Nigeria. Before that time, I may not be able to say categorically whether there has been any significant improvement. The World Health Organization, towards the end of the last millennium, categorized Nigeria a dead zone by reason of the health facilities we have in the hospitals, by reason of the number of medical doctors, medical practitioners we have available per population. So then, offering such services on the platform of ICT became very prominent and significant. What are we saying? That through the instrumentality of ICT, whether you have your mobile device, you have access to your laptop, your desktop computer, you can benefit from health services. And that is why, for a very long time to come, ICT will continue to play a dominant role, not only in healthcare services, but generally in every area of human endeavor. It was also heartwarming to note that the number one university in entrepreneurship is based in Boston. Talking about Babson College, Covenant University pioneered entrepreneurial education in Nigeria. And we have the privilege of training other faculty from other institutions in Nigeria. To us, we are at a level. This is the time for us, we should be looking at the next level, things that we need to do. So that was why the visit to Babson was very significant to us. We visited Babson, we discovered Babson is purely a school of business. They don't do any other thing besides management sciences, business, and particularly entrepreneurship. We were able to have a roundtable discussion. We exchanged ideas, and then we are hoping that we'll be able to forge collaboration that will lead to student staff exchange and to see how we can collaborate equally on our research projects. Talking about innovation, talking about impact, talking about internationalization, from what I mentioned about the number of countries we have visited, even our visit to Harvard alone, and the paper presentation there is enough to convince anybody about how well we have performed on the platform of internationalization. Because as part of the derivables or the deliverables from that visit, we now have a number of faculty from Harvard that will be partnering with us to collaborate with our research cluster in the health sector. Not only that, impact. Looking at a lot of issues we are facing in the nation, heartwarming to say Covenant University emerged number one during the last Webometrics ranking in Nigeria, number one in West Africa, and 15 in Africa. The question is, what has this translated to? To God be the glory, our students are well accepted in the labor market. Employers of labor, they come here to recruit our students, which is a validation of the quality of education that we offer here. Talking about impact. If our products are well absorbed in the industry, that is one. Two, if you look at the research endeavors, talking about the launch of this dual engine automobile that we did, we have a tricycle plying the road. We have two vehicles, one air conditioner, the other not, and they are running. Coming from, the ingenuity of some of the faculty that we have in the university, This is highly commendable. We have a number of our faculty here who are grant winners from the international donors, an attestation to the quality of work and research that the university is doing. And if you look at talking about internationalization, talking about impact, then it leaves nobody in doubt how well we have innovated. So that is why talking about the goal for this year, innovation, impact, and internationalization, we have simply innovated most of the things we do in our laboratory, innovation in the terms of delivery of education in the classrooms, and that has imparted the quality of graduates we produce, the quality of research output from the university, and again, that has enabled us to go to the international communities anywhere in the world to showcase our rich endowment and then begin to see how to collaborate without begging. Because in any relationship, you have two partners bringing certain values, certain virtues to the table for deliberation. It has worked pretty well for us as an institution.